When it comes to New York Rangers prospects that most people would say are quote-unquote problematic in a sense, there's only really one that people talk about, at least a lot. That is Leish Anderson, the Rangers' top pick from the 2017 NHL Entry Draft. He spent some time with the Blue and Red. He also spent some time with the Hartford Wolf Pack, and he eventually left the Hartford Wolf Pack earlier in 2019, vowing to go back to Sweden. Now, speculation has arisen that the only way he is actually going to return to North America is if he gets traded from the Rangers, which I don't know if that's too likely, but at the same time, we just gotta wait and see what's gonna happen. But there is indeed another New York Rangers young guy who is in a spot that I could personally consider as weird. Let's take a look at Vitali Kravtsov, shall we? Vitali Kravtsov is the New York Rangers' top prospect from the next year's draft in 2018. He was taken 9th overall in 2018 in a draft that saw guys like Evan Bouchard, Noah Dobson, Oliver Wahlstrom, and Joel Farabee still on the board. Back when Vitali Kravtsov was drafted, people were quick to point out that this guy wasn't really supposed to go somewhere in the top 9. He was ranked 36th by ISS, 28th by Future Considerations, 6th by HockeyProspect.com, so they were kind of right on the money, but 16th by McKean's, 12th by TSN and Bob McKenzie, so you could see that the rankings for Kravtsov were really diverse, shall we say. But the Rangers took this guy at 9th overall because he was really good for the Traktor Chelyabinsk in the KHL playoffs. He was under a point per game, and he was really, really strong as an 18-year-old player in that league. However, give it a few years in the Hartford Wolfpack system and playing up and down with Russia and going back to Russia this past season, and all of a sudden we have this. This is an interview done for sportexpress.ru. It looks like it's done by a man named Alexei Shevchenko, and he interviews Vitali Kravtsov, and it's really weird. This is a really weird, weird interview that I honestly don't even know how to react. The title of this interview says this. It's a quote from Kravtsov, as noted by the quotation marks, and it's translated from Russian to English via Google Translate. Everyone around me smiled, and then the attitude towards me changed dramatically. The Ranger said that the Russians need to grow up. Now, before we get into this article and we talk about what Kravtsov says about the Rangers, just a disclaimer, a lot of this could indeed be just different cultural ways of speaking interpreted incorrectly, because there are indeed a lot of cultural speak patterns and speak indications that do get lost in translation. So Google Translate is our source here, technically speaking. It may not be 100% correct, but just based off of what I'm reading, I don't really know if it's all that great. Now, for formatting purposes, the bold text is the interviewer, the not bold text is Vitali Kravtsov. The interview asks by starting Kravtsov, hey, when are you going to New York? And Kravtsov says July 3rd. They then ask him, hey, so they're waiting for you in New York, but it's not clear with what mood, what intention, what exactly they plan to do with you. So, the club president says the following, if Kravtsov has not yet matured, we will find another way to develop him. What does that mean? Kravtsov says, I don't know. I read these words on the internet, but no one communicated to me what that actually means. Then the interview asks him, I would understand these words, say, before returning to Traktor last season, but when you returned to America, everything was fine. As I understand it, there were no complaints against you either at work or in relation to what they're talking about here. Then Kravtsov replies, the coach in Hartford and I spoke well after returning. Yes, I started on the fourth line, but I was clearly told, prove everything on the ice. With each match held, time increased. I tried, and it turned out there was something to show for on the ice. Then they ask him, what did you talk about with the coach? And he says, I would not like to tell the details of that conversation. Perhaps this will not be entirely correct, but the conversation was extremely frank and understandable. Rather, even family-like. But what is happening in the family should not be taken out to the public. Of course, I was upset that even after that, I was not called to the Rangers. But this did not affect my work in any way. I did everything I could. So Kravtsov says that he had a conversation with the Hartford Wolf Pack coach indicating that his time on the fourth line is going to be promoted to higher minutes as Kravtsov starts working and producing a little bit more. He says that it was frank and that was fine and it was good to see that. But he's confused about the narrative that has been thrown around about Kravtsov recently in the media saying, hey, he hasn't matured yet. And all of a sudden here, the narrative is that Kravtsov has to grow up. That's what the interview says, and Kravtsov says this: I sincerely don't understand exactly what I should grow up in. I live alone. I can cook food at home. Seriously, I myself would like to understand the essence of the claims. I hope when I come to New York, they will talk to me about this topic. But before that, there was no contact with the club. Nobody called me, nobody wrote me, I didn't talk to anyone except my agent, and he didn't have any complaints about me either. And that paragraph is why I wanted to make a video about this, because this is so weird, isn't it? It's incredibly weird to see Vitali Kravtsov coming public about the mixed signals, quote-unquote, that the New York Rangers have been giving him. They told him in the AHL that he's got to work hard, and he was satisfied with that. But once he left the Hartford Wolfpack and he went back over to the Traktor Chelyabinsk in the KHL, all of a sudden there's this other narrative that's forming around him that he had no idea that was going on. But why did he even leave to the KHL in the first place? He says there were reasons, but I will return to what he spoke about in the conversation with the coach. Let the personal remain personal. Everything was within the team. He also says this about returning back to Russia. You see, at first, everything was good in New York. Training camp, exhibition matches, everyone was smiling, and then the attitude changed dramatically. I was sent to Hartford, and in the first match, I only spent 5 minutes of playing time. Why? And again, without details, but I didn't do anything wrong. So Kravtsov here is talking about how everybody was positive and everybody was up and away happy about how things were going, and then he got sent to Hartford and played 5 minutes a night. The interviewer also asks about a certain controversy with Vitali Kravtsov when he didn't celebrate when scoring a goal. And Kravtsov says this: we work in training camp and during the preseason meetings, we need to show how to play, not how you rejoice. Well, I scored a goal. I was driving. They gave me a pass, threw it on goal. What is there to rejoice? This is an unofficial game. You want to say that my mood was in the way? I don't think so. I always smile. Really. The next parts of the interview go over Kravtsov in the KHL and eventually going to the VHL. He spent some time up and down in Russia, but eventually the article circles back to the Rangers discussion, and he says, I understand that you want to talk about the full picture of this previous season, but it will not work. I can't talk about some things, some of which remained incomprehensible to me. So it's better to completely forget about all this. It's just that in this story, there are no heroes or people who were guilty of absolutely everything. Then, honestly, the interview kind of goes into a little bit of an argumentative tone. The interviewer says, it seems to me that you, Vitali Kravtsov, have a problem with the perception of other people's words and other people's criticisms. Kravtsov says, hey, no, I deleted all of my applications with Sports News. I try not to read this stuff, but it doesn't always work out. And then the interviewer says, Vitali, you were the 9th overall pick in the 2018 draft. Of course all your steps will be discussed. And the rest of this interview is so, so weird. It's got a really strange flavor to it. So I highly recommend you read this interview. I'll leave a link in the description below. Obviously, again, this is the caveat. This could just be Google Translate not really translating some things properly and having a few intentions lost in translation. So there's that. But just based off of the Google Translate version of this interview, Vitali Kravtsov's in a weird spot, and I don't really know how certain I am personally, and confident I am personally, to say that he is going to come into training camp for the New York Rangers and actually do things the way that the Rangers would like him to do. He's spoken a whole bunch about miscommunication and mixed signals and the Rangers not communicating to him what they want out of him. He's talked about the media and all that. I don't really know if this is going to be super stable going into the immediate short-term future. Sure, do I still think Vitali Kravtsov has some really good NHL potential in 5 years? Yes, absolutely. It's just, For the next few months, I don't know what's going to happen, and we will see how everything evolves as this story goes on. I hope we get an update on this. I hope we see some more Vitali Kravtsov interviews, because this was just weird. Again, read the description for the link to the article. I hope you enjoyed this video. Comment down below what you think about Vitali Kravtsov and what we talked about here today. Social Dash Ross 99, and bye.